Hi, hello. My name is Marina. I'm 57 and I live in Sweden. Today I actually is going to do a collab video, my first ever, and I am so happy about that. It is with Erica Conger, and I actually think I have learned how to put a link in my description box, so if you see it there, that means that I have succeeded in that. So please go and watch her too. She's amazing. Yes, so we're doing a collab, and I'm so grateful for her to ask me, that she asked me. It's the first one I ever do, and it's about ageism. The tag is originally created by Debbie at Vinyl Beauty, and I'll see if I can link her too. Since we all are a little bit older, I think I'm the oldest one. This is going to be so much fun. I was actually almost jumping up and down when Erica asked me. I'm very honored. Thank you, Erica. And thank you also for all your help. For those of you that don't know, that's all of you. She helped me with the thumbnail. And if you see it here in the beginning of the video, that means that I succeeded to put it there. Otherwise, I failed. But she helped me do it one nevertheless. Thank you. So, I have actually been watching Debbie's video about this, and I think I've seen it 3 times because it's really good. Oh, and yes, the palette, I almost forgot. Erica and me decided to use this one, Lilac You A Lot by Colourpop, because this is one that we have in common, and for her, she haven't even used hers. I had mine for quite some time, so I have used it a few times, and this is also my favorite color, purple. Looks like this. I really do think that it's lacking a really deep matte shadow. I would have loved it to be one of these. This one should have been a bit darker, according to me, but that's just me. So if this wasn't a collab, I would have pulled in a black one or a darker purple or a dark blue or something like that. But I won't do that today since we're using only this one. Yes, so the questions. There are 10 questions. I have wrote them down on a piece of paper that I have next to me. And I hope I will be able to answer them properly. It's in English, so of course I have sometimes difficulties. The first question is, to what degree do you think society / social norms influence the makeup we wear as we get older? I think they do a lot. We see a lot of stuff in different social medias and, you know, glossy magazines, and they are all mostly focused towards younger people, and they tell you not to do this and not to wear that and so on, and I think it's easy to get influenced. So yes, I think they do influence in a negative way. I forgot to put my makeup on. Okay, I will start with, this is going to be difficult, talking about thinking and put makeup on at the same time. we will see how I will succeed with this. I will start with this pinky purpley shade called Ghostin and put that in my crease. I have also prepared my face as usual. I don't know if you want to see, but okay, this is by a Swedish brand called Kix, and this one doesn't exist anymore because they have rebranded. It's an illuminating primer. I used my beloved HD Liquid Coverage Foundation Sand Beige by Catrice. Oh, I don't have it here now, but my powder is the cheap one by Dollar Store. Just a cheap one. Bronzer in Chocolate Soleil by Too Faced. This is a sample. My brows are Dip Brow Brow Pomade, medium brown as usual. And I primed my lids with eye primer by Anastasia. My blush is by Sleek Makeup in the color Pixie Pink. I will put on my highlighter later on, and now I'm forgetting everything. Powder under my eyes. I have used this palette before, as I said, but I can't remember if there is any fallout. So I'll do this just a precaution, like that. So, Ghostin, pinky purpley shade. I love this type of pink. So the second question. At what age do you think it's inappropriate to wear makeup that's traditionally seen as more youthful, like color, glitter, etc.? Never. Why should it be? I use a lot of glitter and I use a lot of color. I love colorful looks. Why should it not? Because you're older? I don't know. So the answer is never. You do whatever you like. Be honest. Question number three. Have you ever looked at an older person and thought they should not be wearing makeup anymore, as they are too old to make it look good? Tricky one. No, I don't think I have. Not in the way that they shouldn't use makeup because they're old. I would never think that. But I have seen horrible examples of older women, how they apply their makeup, the skills. That could be changed, and I still think that. But even so, I think it's great that they're at least trying, and if it makes them feel better, make them get more confident or whatever, just wear it. But I see a lot of older women that maybe could need a lesson or two. That don't mean, I'm not implying that I am any better than anyone else, but I don't think they shouldn't wear makeup, of course not. I'm all for it. Just go ahead. If it makes you feel better, which it does, if you ask me. Yes. I have to be close, otherwise I can't see. When watching YouTube, do you tend to watch channels from creators of a similar age to you, or do you think it doesn't matter? It doesn't matter. I can watch, doesn't matter age. I watch whatever, but I came on YouTube because I wanted to find people in my own age. because there isn't many, especially not in real life. So I thought maybe I could find someone that likes makeup as much as I do on YouTube. And I had found friends. So that's great. I'm still the oldest one. But to me, if I find someone that is 20 and I like what she's doing, it doesn't matter. Age doesn't matter. It's who you are in here that matters. Yes. Question number 5. Does ageism exist in the beauty world? If you think it does, where does it originate from? Well, again, I think it's media. I think ageism is everywhere, not only in the beauty community. In Sweden, it's horrible when it comes to work, finding new jobs and things like that. If you're too old, you won't get it. But yes, it does exist in the beauty world. And I think media has a big influence there. I forget to put my makeup on. Now I will take the Iffy. This is a gorgeous purple. I love it. I could swim in this one. No, that's one too soft. Soft. My pencil was too soft. Yeah, because you're so... It's so easy to get influenced by what you see on in papers and, you know, all these glossy magazines and YouTube and Instagram and all of that. And it's difficult not to get pulled in. And think that you have to be in a certain way. When you really don't. Going back to the ghost in shadow because it's kind of disappeared. I will be really excited to see what Erica did. What look she's doing with this palette. Too soft pencil. I need brush. I mean, I keep saying pencil. Because in Swedish it's pencil. Why should age stop you? I don't know. Why shouldn't you do the things that you have always done? Because you're on the inside, you're still the same. I have said this before and I will say it again. I just wish that girls and women that are in their, for say example, in their 20s, could understand that just because you see a certain type of skin doesn't mean that your head is 57 as well. I will never forget. I actually had a moment when I realized, how should I explain this, that people don't see me when they look at me as the age I was feeling I was. That's bad English. Because in my head, I'm always like 25. And then I looked at myself in the mirror and I realized I don't look 25 anymore. And I'm behaving like it. And people will see that I'm not 25. And that just kind of hit me like a rock. And I think that was when I started to maybe change how I acted when I was with younger women and girls, because I was kind of taking for granted that I wanted to be with me, wanted to say and do the same things that I did. And I realized, my gosh, I'm older than them. They think I'm an old woman. And I don't feel like it. I can't explain this, but it just came to me, it just like in a second, when I was standing in front of the mirror one day, and I think I was actually putting on my makeup, I can't remember, but I suddenly realized that my face doesn't no longer look like I feel on the inside. And that was a awakening. And you keep on being there in your head, but your face and your body won't be there. I can tell you. Well, next question. Number six. Do brands do enough to attract cater for the over 40s? Do you think there is, I can say this word, untapped potential there? No, they don't. If I understand the question correctly, they cater through to younger people, which is a shame, because if you want to sell a product, or if you want lots of people to go after what you're trying to sell, I guess people over 40s can maybe have a larger wallet. We have the means a bit more than you had when you were in your 20s. I am now taking filtered, that one, in my outer corner. And also in all the advertising, there's always younger girls. It's getting better though. You can see it more and more, but not enough, I think. Older people in advertising and all of that. And I don't know what they're thinking about. Why not? We're here and we're still alive and kicking. And maybe we can afford it a bit more. You have a more steady economy than you had when you were in your 20s. So, yes, I think there should be more. There is more potential if they could just realize it. Question number seven. Do you do anything to counteract aging, or do you think it doesn't matter? I don't do a thing. I don't use anti-aging products. I hardly use skincare at all. Well, of course, I have cleansing things for my face. I have one cleanser for my eye makeup and one for the face, and I use tonic afterwards, and I always moisturize my face every morning and every night, but there's not with expensive stuff, just cheap stuff from my grocery store. Yes, and I have never more powder, used expensive stuff, because I have no problem with my skin. I have never had. I guess I have to thank my mother for that. She's the same. And I don't have problems with acne, anything like that. Now I am using this one called Trainwreck. And I will spray this one because I think maybe it doesn't have so much color payoff. This is only water with some glycerin in it. Yes, no, I don't do a lot counteracting my age. I just go along and hope for the best. I really would like to learn a bit more about skincare, because I don't know a lot, but I think it feels very complicated. So I kind of never set my mind to learn about it. And if you want to, I don't feel like spending a lot of money on expensive skincare products. I'd rather put them on makeup. And I also believe that if you are going to use anti-aging products, I think, isn't it that so that you should start using them before you start aging to prevent you or to slow down the process? It's too late to start when you're already in your 60s, I think. But I don't know a lot about that, so I might be wrong. I would have liked a really dark color here now, because I don't think this one is dark enough, but sticking to the palette. What do you think, Erica? Would you have liked a darker one? I'm really curious what she's doing. Oh, there's a really beautiful shift when you push this shadow over the lighter one. I think there's too little differences between the shadows. You can see where one starts and the other one ends. So, well, you're gonna get old anyway, whether you use expensive or cheap skincare, nevertheless. Question number 8. In your mind, do you equate, I don't know, aging with a diminishing of beauty? No. Aging has nothing to do with beauty, if you ask me. It sounds maybe ridiculous. Beauty comes from the inside, but I think actually it's a whole lot of truth in that. Doesn't matter how pretty your face is and how beautiful you are. If you're acting like an asshole, then you're not beautiful anymore. It's who you are. Of course you can have a pretty face, but if you are not a pretty person, it doesn't matter. If you ask me, age has nothing to do with beauty. You can be so beautiful when you're 90 or when you're 10. I must say, this is not the best purple I have. Purples are difficult. And this one kind of goes, you blend it away. So this is a bit messy. So that's that. Question number 9. Name a channel that you would recommend as someone who challenges ageism in the beauty community and shows that anyone can wear whatever you want. I don't know if you're just supposed to name one. I have a couple. First of all, the one who came up with this tag, Debbie at Vinyl Beauty. I love her. She's 52, I think, and she does the most gorgeous looks. She's really, really brave when it comes to colors and winged out looks and yeah, the whole shebang. She does it gracefully. And she also a very calming and soothing person to listen to. I always enjoy her videos. And of course, Nikkie at Nikkie Raven. She's hilarious. I love her too. She's 44, I think. To me, just a child. I'm kidding. She's funny. She does gorgeous looks. She talks a lot and explains a lot about how to apply things and all of that when your skin is getting a little bit older. So you can learn a lot from her. She's really good at that. She has her own style and I love that. And also I found a channel through Debbie. Oh my gosh, now I can't remember. She's in her 60s too. She's a goth and she has completely not my style of makeup or clothes and hair, nothing at all like what I would be comfortable in, but I adore her for daring to have that style in her age. She had shaved eyebrows and I can't remember her name. I can't look it up because I'm filming with my phone. If I remember, I will. And if I can, I will link her too. She's British. I can't remember at the moment. No. Yeah. And of course, Erica. But you're young. Yes, you are. yeah. They do whatever they want. And I love that. So question number 10, and I'm not even half through my makeup yet, okay. What tips do you have to anyone older who wants to venture into colorful or bold eye looks? Well, just go for it. No one will bite you. Just do it. It washes off. Practice before the at home in mirror. Practice at home before you leave the house. If you don't feel comfortable, put it on, be indoors, pass through a mirror every now and then. When you're not longer scared of what you're seeing in the mirror, then it's okay. Then you have gotten used to it. Just walk outdoors. Easy. You would be surprised. People not going to react, at least not in a negative way. I have always been using a lot of makeup. I'm not discreet in any way. And I have a job where I meet a lot of people every day. And I never get anything else but compliments on my makeup. And I hear so, so many women saying, oh, I wish I could do it like you do it. And oh, I wish I dared to do that. But just do it. It's nothing dangerous. You will just get compliments. And you always get happy when you get compliments. It lifts you up. And it's not scary. Well, it might be scary to dare in the beginning, but I have never had anything else but positive reactions. Once, I sell glasses for a living. I need to focus on my makeup. What shall I do under my eyes? I think I will just continue with the dark one because now I'm talking too much. I was helping an older man picking his glasses. I wore, at that day I had black lips at work. And a colleague said to him, "Well, here is Marina, she's going to help you." And he looked at me and said, "You look dangerous." Well, I helped him. And before we was done, I said to him, "You see, I'm not so dangerous." And then he just laughed. And that was funny. And I think he was joking with me. He didn't mean that I was dangerous in any way. But it was his way in commenting. I can't talk on my lipstick. But otherwise, just the other day, I had finished work and I was in the grocery store and I came to pay for my stuff, and the woman, cashier, the one who was I was going to pay to, said, "Oh, are you going to a party? You're beautiful. What are you going to do now?" And I said, "No, I have been working. I'm just on my way home." And it's comments like that I get a lot, and it makes you happy. So just go for it. But I mean that thing with practicing at home. Put makeup on more than you feel comfortable in. Try colors that you are not used to wearing and wear it at home. Pass by a mirror every now and then. And when you no longer react to what you look like, you will have been gotten used to it, I think. So that's a way to, well, get used to it. I'm rambling. Of course, the powder. This is too bright for me. I would like to have something darker, but okay, it is what it is. I am actually going to put on blue eyeliner. And as per usual, this eye never gets how I want it. So, this is the Cake It Water Activated Liner. This is a duochrome liner by Artitude Cosmetics. And I have some water here, so I'm just taking where did I put it? Here it is. My eyeliner brush. Sorry. It's so confusing. In Swedish, makeup brush is pensel. So I want to say pen. Pencil. No, that's something else. So I'm just dipping the brush in water, and then I just swirl it around in here till I get a consistency that I like. I hope you're having more luck with the shadows than I have had. This is not a look that I am satisfied with, Erica. Oh, and I would like to say, if you are here from Erica's channel, you're very welcome. That's a late for me to say that now. I should have said that in the beginning. I hope you like what you see, and maybe you would like to subscribe. I would be ever so grateful. I'm sorry you can't see what I'm doing. Erica has been the most sweetest person to me. I don't know how she found my channel, because I kind of don't exist. And she started to write to me, and she's so sweet and friendly. And she asked me to collab, and I almost cried. This is exactly what I want with YouTube, making new friends. And I think this collab, starting with an ageism thing, that was really great. Because, well, this age thing is really annoying. You're really the same person that you've always been. Well, of course you're mature, and of course you will change a little bit. Life changes you. It happens to everybody. Things you go through. But it doesn't mean you're some other person. Debbie at Vinyl Beauty said something like, it's not like you're gonna stop doing what you all have always done, sit down in a rocking chair and knit. I do knit, but I have done that my whole life. I've done that since I was kind of 16. You don't change, you're still the same inside. And I wish younger people and society, beauty, community could realize that. But it is what it is. This is my mascara, Bambi Oversized Eye by L'Oreal. New, never used. I think the beauty community would have a lot to gain if they could embrace older people a bit more. We have experience, we have well, everything that you don't have when you're in your 20s. And I also wish that more older women and men dared to come on to YouTube. I was really hesitant in the beginning, just because of my age. Who would like to see a wrinkly old woman put their makeup on? Who? But then I found, well, people in my own age, Nick Raven, Debbie, and some more. And then I thought, if they can, I can. So here I am. Inner corner highlight. This is, it doesn't have any name, just a highlight, a galactic purple by 5050 Makeup. Really love this brand. I talked about it before. And I always use my pinky for my inner corner. Actually ordered a few of their 5050s duochromes. I think it was multichromes, duochromes, I don't remember. They should be here any day now, for perhaps maybe tomorrow. This is, when I'm filming this, it's Tuesday the 22nd, and this will be uploaded tomorrow on the 23rd. Can't wait to see what Erica has done. Really curious about that. Highlighter on my cheek, and I'm using, I always forget to talk about my brushes. This is a Kaleidos H1 highlighter brush. Why do you always do funny faces when you put makeup on, I wonder? If you don't look old before you do funny faces, you will do when you do funny faces. Or your wrinkles. Look at this. I don't know if you can see it because my camera, when I do this, I'm look, lots of wrinkles. Yes. What can you do? You will all get there eventually. Blush, I think I'll take some more blush. And I always take a big blush to just swirl it together. Big blush, big brush. This is going to be a long video. You will just have to bear with me, or you have to fast forward. Like so. And for once I remembered to decide what lip to use. It's not, this is Lip Erase by MAC. To take away your natural color. I feel that I have been rambling. Sorry. And this is not a new one either. It's collaboration between L'Oreal and Balmain. The lipstick is called Freedom Purple. I never ever put my lipstick on just like that. Brush. At least not a bullet lipstick. sorry, quiet. Thought maybe you need to rest your ears for a minute. Now I can do, oops. Yeah, enough is enough. And for my waterline, I guess I'm done. Tomorrow I'm gonna cut my hair. This is too long. Yes, so I hope I have not been rambling on too much. I know this is a long one. One of these days I will going to learn how to edit. You just have to bear with me and look at me in twice the speed maybe. I hope I have made any sense. Erica, thank you so much for wanting to do this with me. I will gladly collab with you again. Yeah, thank you. Oh, close up. I almost forgot. But this is not, I wasn't satisfied at all with this. It's a bit patchy and I would have liked the outer corner to be darker. But I'm just gonna wash it off. Yes. Okie dokie. Thank you again, Erica, and I talk to you soon. And to everybody else, hope you're having a fantastic day or night or whatever you are doing. See you later and be careful out there. Bye bye.